So I've been gravitating towards wines. Some even giving up their hard liquor or even the beers for the healthier wines. Tonight, we take a short course in wine appreciation. I'm Manu Ari, and you're watching A Slice of Life. OBB. Okay, our guest for this evening is multifaceted. He's a world traveler. He's actually more used to being behind the camera or behind the scene because he is also a writer, a production designer for several commercials and TV stations in Manila. He is a writer, columnist for several broadsheets, and he does work behind the house or back of the house in the restaurant. He's the executive chef of Titania Wine Cellar, and he will be our guest tonight. And something special about him, he graduated from Le Cordon Bleu de Paris. That is renowned as the best culinary school in the world, and he will be our guest tonight. So please welcome Chef René Emmanuel Arambolo. Chef.
Hello.
Good evening. Thank you for finding time to visit us. You went to the most well-known culinary school. Tell us something about that school and why did you choose to go to that school?
Well, actually, when I started, I really wasn't into cuisine, right? But my father, he opened a restaurant. I was living in LA at the time,
Okay.
right? So he opened a restaurant and he made me run it. I was in school. I really had no way of controlling, let's say, the costing of the kitchen because I had no inkling about
Food
cooking,
costs and
yeah,
the
about
rest,
food
yeah.
costs and all that. So I decided I wanted to go to culinary school, and the first thing that came to mind was the best one.
Only the best for you, of course. Only the best for Chef.
The best, which was Cordon Bleu de Paris.
Okay. But
Okay, the
during the
only drawback there was I had to learn how to speak French first
Okay.
because all the courses there are in French.
So is your French fluent after all the years that you've
Yes,
spent?
when I was there, yes, it was fluent.
Oh, okay.
But
Very
after the
good.
years, I guess it dropped.
Practice lang yan,
Yeah, it just
practice
needs
lang.
practice.
Okay. Aside from being the executive chef of Titania Wine Cellar, you're also a sommelier. A
Yes.
sommelier is a person who specializes in wine. So not only is he the executive chef, he's also the sommelier. Chef, tell us something. If I wanted to learn about wines, or you're teaching a group about wines, what would be the first thing that you would be teaching them about?
Well, okay, the first thing would be there are two kinds. There's a red wine and a white wine.
Okay.
Okay, and basically the flavors that you're looking for in a white wine, there are actually two, which is in white wine, it's the acidity and the sweetness. So you have to look for a balance there. Okay, in red wines, there are three. You have the bitterness, which comes from the tannins, from the skin of the grapes.
Okay.
Okay, then you still have the acidity and the sweetness. So when you talk about a balanced wine, you're talking of a flavor that's in between where you can't taste the acidity,
Yes.
you can't taste the sweetness, or you can't taste the bitterness.
Okay, and among the Filipinos, what is do we prefer, red wine or white wine?
I think they like red.
And why is that, Chef, among the Filipinos?
I guess first of all, I know their doctors tell them it's good for the heart.
Yes.
Okay, the red wine has a an antioxidant, which is a polyphenol, called polyphenol, right? And it actually is used to combat cholesterol.
Okay. So that would make it perfect, especially for this Christmas, to those who are having lechon. If you're having lechon, have that with your red wine. As Chef said, good for the cholesterol.
Yeah.
What do you call it? Is it red, the trend the same worldwide that most people take red instead of white wine?
I see here that most foreigners, like let's say Americans or Europeans, who tend to veer for the white wines,
okay,
because they're chilled with the temperature here, the climate. I mean, in Manila.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess they would prefer chilled wines.
Okay. But okay. Red wine is supposed to be served at room temperature.
Yes.
So are we talking like room temperature Baguio or room temperature
in
Manila?
Yeah, in Baguio. Room temperature.
Okay. So we'd be talking about like 18, 19 degrees.
Yes.
Something like that.
Yes, exactly. So that actually, there we chill the wines like 5-10 minutes.
Yes.
That's it, and then we take it out of the ref.
Okay.
The chiller.
And in your travels, I know you've been like all over Europe, and I'm sure you've tried all different kinds of wines. Where do you think the best wines come from?
For me personally, I like the wines from South America, from Chile, and from Argentina.
Okay.
The my favorite actually grape variety is the Malbec grape. Malbec grape.
Okay.
And the Carmenere grape, which actually come from Chile and Argentina.
Any particular region there that it comes from?
Yes, in Argentina, it's from the Mendoza region, province. And in Chile, the Carmenere comes from the Colcagua region.
Oh, okay. And normally in the restaurant, well, when they order and they call like the sommelier and they ask them, ano bagay dito, you know, with my dish? I'm having chicken, I'm having fish. Is there a general rule of thumb what kind of wine you have?
Yes,
like
there was before. I mean, normally with white meat, you take white wine.
Oh, okay.
And then with red meat, you take red wine. But I guess with nowadays, I would think differently. I would look at the sauce. So if your sauce is basically a heavy sauce, like a red sauce, brown sauce, I would go with the red wine, even if it was fish. Mm-hmm. Like I normally do, like salmon.
Okay.
And it has
one of my favorite fish, salmon.
I do it with a brown sauce.
Yes. Salmon with a brown sauce.
Yes. Okay. So I would use a red wine with salmon.
Oh, interesting.
Now, if I have like a fillet of sole.
Yes.
Okay, which is white, and it had a white cream sauce.
Yes.
Base. I would go for white.
Oh, okay. Interesting. Not only, what do you call this? So, chef is the executive chef, but it's something interesting about the restaurant that he works in. They do have a set menu, but he's got his regular guests. They actually call him. And he comes up with dishes as per their request. So, it's not on the menu, and then they come in and ask for something special. Tell us something about this chef.
Oh, yes. Because normally when they go there, they're thinking of drinking a particular wine.
Okay. So do they start like, you know, I'm taking this wine, chef, can you pair it with a certain
kind of food?
Yes. Oh, okay.
They're looking for that.
Oh, okay.
So, for instance, they get a very expensive wine, like a 10,000 peso bottle of wine.
Oh, that's costly, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so they'd like something that would go with it.
Yes.
You know, so what I do is, I actually formulate something for them.
So it's right there in
them. Yeah. I ask them, like, do you want fish? Do you want meat? Mm-hmm. Do you want something heavy, something light? Okay. And then from there, I just create something for them.
Oh, that's something. That's an excellent concept. So you can see, I guess you can see how good a chef is when they can make something like there on the spot and make with whatever they do. And chef, what do you call this? In your world travels, and especially in France, we're talking about like French cuisine. And normally, I had a chance to fly to Paris when I was usually with the airlines. So when I think of French food, I think of like small portions and then tons of butter. Eh, sa Pinoy, like, you know, parang sinisinghot ko lang to, yung ganyang kalit. And I want something like really huge. But you're saying it's not really the way French cuisine
that's
is.
That's actually just in Paris.
Okay.
Okay, it was the nouvelle cuisine, it's called.
The small portions.
Where actually it's called a degustation, where you just get to try bits and pieces.
Degustation.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. It was actually formulated by Paul Bocuse in the 1980s.
Okay.
Okay, and then it became synonymous with French cuisine, and they really popularized it in New York also.
Yes. But it's not exactly what French.
No,
you're saying in the south of France.
Yeah, you go to the south of France. You go. Yes. Up north of Paris, like to the Burgundy region, and when they serve the food, they actually serve them in large portions.
Really huge portions,
yes,
like
in Filipino style. They put it in the middle, and everyone shares.
Oh, okay. Now that's the way the food should be served, not yung like parang Small portions lang.
Yes.
Okay, cool.
And I try and do that. So when my customers ask for special dishes, I do it like that. I serve it in French provincial manner. The way it should be.
Okay.
Enjoyed.
So for they choose the wines, and afterwards the dish comes with it also. Now, wine pairing doesn't only mean trying to pair it with food. We also have wine pairing that goes with some cheeses, which we'll be doing later on. Cheeses and some chocolates. Can you give us some tips on how to pair different cheeses and some chocolates?
Actually, with chocolates, I would go with sparkling wines. Which are a bit on the dry side, but they have a sweet aroma to it. Okay. For cheeses, I think all red wines will go with cheese.
Any red wine.
And I would normally go for the aged red wines, which are normally the reserved wines, which are normally reserva wines are aged for 12 months in a French oak barrel or American oak barrel.
Okay.
And a Grand Reserve would go for 24 months onward.
Okay.
So it doesn't mean if your bottle is old, if the vintage on your bottle is old, doesn't mean that it actually lasts long. It has to be pre-aged in a barrel before it's aged in the bottle.
So by the time, do you have a 12 months and a 24 months? So by the time it's bottled already, how long before? Because we think now, it's been there for quite a while. Does it really turn stale or turn into vinegar after a certain
time?
No,
that depends on the quality of the grapes. Normally, high-quality grapes have good aging potential, so they can be aged.
Okay.
Well, young wines, like maybe they'll be aged for 3 months, I guess. Yes. The red ones will only last for like 7 years, and the white ones will go up to 4. After that, they become oxidized.
So they're stale by the time. So it turns into vinegar.
Vinegar, or what the term would be, is it becomes watery. So it loses its flavor.
So it's not even good for cooking?
For cooking, it's perfect.
Cooking. So at least when it goes stale.
Especially the white wines, when they turn sour, into vinegar, they're really good with the food for cooking.
Okay. Now, when we open a bottle of wine, can we cork it afterwards and then drink it 1 or 2 days after? It's not like I open one, then I have to consume it already.
No. They last normally 3 days open.
Oh, 3 days. So pwede pala yon.
Yeah.
Okay. And is it the same for both red wines or white
wines?
Or does a certain one stay
longer
than the
other?
Normally,
if I uncork a bottle of white wine, I'd put it in the chiller.
Okay.
When I recork it.
I've seen different kinds of corks. There are some special gadgets that they use so it doesn't become stale. Does it really matter?
No, actually, for me, it doesn't.
It doesn't?
We actually, at Titania, we do sell them too. Yeah. But for me, the moment the oxygen touches the wine, there's contact with the air, it already starts to. It will turn bad after 3 days, whether you vacuum it or aerate it.
Okay. So that's our start. What we call this our first segment. And when we come back, we'll be doing wine. We'll be doing wine pairing. And take note. We'll be giving away wines care of Titania wine cellar. And the first question is, what is the whole name of Chef Rene? So the first question, what is the whole name of Chef Rene? Please text in your answers. It should be in your screen right now. And whoever gets it right gets a bottle of wine care of Titania Wine Cellar. Stay tuned and we'll be back.
Actually,
Shalane! Shalane is now Solane!
Solane!
Solane! Solane! Shalane is now Solane! The quality you track, now Solane!
Tonight, Chef Renee. Before anything else, I'd like to acknowledge the presence in the studio of Ms. Lisa Agot of Business Mirror. Ading, kumusta ngay? And also, happy viewing to the Solane family. We hope you're enjoying the show. I'd like to announce, by the way, the contest that we're having in January. We're holding a cooking contest between the schools. And the major prize for this cooking contest is going to be a one-month apprenticeship with Forest House and you get to present your dish at the Forest House. So for those who are interested, you can text the number that you see on the screen, or you can drop by Forest House. Again, we have a contest ongoing right now. We're giving out several bottles of wine. And the first question was, what is the full name of Chef Renee? Okay, so the contest is still ongoing. Text your answers. And the second question is, what school did Chef Renee go to? Hint, if you don't know, try to Google it. Best culinary institute in the world. That's a hint. Okay, so we're back with Chef Renee, and we're going to do a short course in wine tasting. Chef?
Okay, so now we're going to be trying some wine with cheeses. Okay. As I said a while ago, they're actually the best thing that pairs with wine. Okay, I have four wines here. I have one from Italy, one from Spain, one from France, okay, and one from Chile. Okay, and we're going to start off with a blue cheese.
That's a pretty strong cheese, huh?
Yes, blue it's cheese. Actually French cheese, Roquefort cheese.
Okay.
And I'm going to pair that off with the Cabernet Sauvignon.
Okay. Is there a particular reason, Chef, why we're using Cabernet Sauvignon?
Yes, actually Cabernet Sauvignon for me is the grape variety with the strongest flavor.
Okay.
And I think it's the best one that will pair with the blue cheese, which is really pungent. It has a really strong flavor.
Okay.
Okay, so would you like to?
Okay. Actually, it's one of my favorites, blue cheese. Strong, pungent.
Should I put more or just?
Just a little bit, Chef.
Okay.
I'm actually the perfect student for chef because actually I don't drink. Therefore, it would be nice for me to learn all this stuff. So, education for Manong Ari.
Okay, first, you have to swirl
the
glass.
So, swirl it a bit.
Yes, to aerate, have the oxygen into the
So, we
wine.
Swirl it.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Swirling.
Okay, you take a sniff. Like this. And then
that smells
a
good.
Sip.
And a sip.
Yes.
I can get used to this, huh?
Yeah. So now try it with a bit of cheese. You have the cheese first and then...
So we take a little bit of cheese and right after cheese we do the...
Yes, the wine.
Okay, we do the wine. Okay. Join me, chef.
I will in a while.
Okay.
You see how the flavor of the cheese sort of changes?
Never tried that before.
You have a third flavor there.
Right. I could learn to love this. Okay.
Okay.
Next, chef.
Okay, next. We're going to try Gouda cheese.
It's called Gouda?
Yes, this is from Holland.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to have this with Spanish wine. This is a reserve wine, I was saying a while ago. Reserve wines are aged for 12 months. So when you uncork it, actually you have to leave it open for 30 minutes. To let it breathe a bit because it's been in the bottle for a long, long time.
Okay, so this is Spanish?
Yes, this is Spanish Viñal Valley Reserva.
And we're pairing this with Gouda.
We're pairing this with Gouda.
With Gouda, okay.
Okay. The reason actually they age wines is to soften the bitterness, the tannins. The tannins.
Is it the longer the aging, the better?
Yes, actually the wine becomes smoother. You lose the bitterness. Okay. Especially for red wine. That's the reason actually they age it, is to remove the bitterness.
Okay.
So since this is reserved, it's going to be a bit smoother, and that's why I'm going to pair it with the Gouda cheese.
With the Gouda. Okay.
Which is less tangy. There. And then now, you can have a sip of your wine. Put this back. See how the flavor changes?
It is smoother.
Yeah.
Like they say, mas konti yung sabit niya. This one tastes better.
That's actually why you say sabit, because actually the nerve that senses alcohol is actually the back of the tongue. So when they say gumuguhit, it's because you can feel the alcohol back there.
Oh. Okay, so ito like maganda yung guhit nito.
Yes. And plus normally reserve wines would have a higher percentage of alcohol. Normally, wines would go up to 14% alcohol.
Oh, okay. Wait, 14%, is it in general what wines are, or there are some wines with a higher alcohol content?
Actually, not higher. Maybe up to 14.5, but they'd go lower.
Yes.
See, when wine is fermented, actually, you're converting the sugar from the grape juice into alcohol. Yes. So, the higher the alcohol content, the less sugar you would have, residual sugar. Okay. The lower the alcohol content, then there's a bit of sugar left, so it will be sweet.
Oh.
So, if you're looking for a wine, actually, that you want a wine that's sweet, you look for the alcohol content. You'll see it on the bottle, it would say like 11 or 12%.
So, that would be sweet.
Yes, it would be on the sweet side.
Okay, so we've done the Spanish wine with Gouda. What do we have next, chef?
Okay, next we have Parmigiano Reggiano in Italian. Okay, this one is a bit on the... pungent side, it's a bit sour, acidic. Okay, so we're gonna try this off with an Italian wine from the Chianti. This is a Chianti Reserve. It's also been aged for 12 months in a French oak barrel. Okay, so we're gonna have this. I'm gonna pour. There.
So this is a Chianti, and
Chianti is actually from the Tuscany region.
Okay.
And the Tuscany region, they say, is like a fried egg, and the yolk would be Chianti. So all the best wines
is all from that certain portion.
Yes, the grapes actually from Italy are called Sangiovese grapes.
Oh,
it's a grape variety which actually translate into the blood of Jupiter.
Interesting. Okay, so let's check out the blood of Jupiter. So we're matching this, so we're pairing this with
Parmesan cheese.
Is this similar to the Parmesan cheese that we use, that we normally have in the container we use for spaghetti toppings?
Yes.
Same thing.
Yeah, but this one is fresh and freshly.
So pwede natin grate to over the spaghetti.
Yes.
Okay, let's try this.
Okay.
Ang queso de bola, chef?
Yeah. Actually, this one will be Kesselbol. This is an Edam cheese.
Oh, okay.
Amsterdam. You see how the flavors...
I love the combination of the flavors,
You see, the reason... Actually, I find that Spanish and Italian wines are a bit on the acidic side. It's because it best pairs with the food of the Spanish and Italian food, which is salty.
Yes.
And so the pairing you have there would sort of be like salt and vinegar chips. You have the saltiness and the sourness, or the tartiness, and that's the one that actually brings out the flavor of the cheese.
Good combination. Love that.
Okay.
Okay, next we have...
And last we have Old Amsterdam cheese.
Old Amsterdam cheese.
Okay, so this has been aged.
Okay.
For a long time.
When you say age, how long? Are we talking like another 10 years for the cheese or something?
No, this one has been aged probably 2 years.
2 years.
Yes.
Okay, 2 years.
Okay, so we're going to pair it with a Calitera Reserva. This is from Chile. And as I mentioned, the grape variety typical of Chile is the Carmenere grape. Which is, you'll see, it's a bit spicy. It has a bit of spiciness to it. So we're going to try that with this cheese. I'm not even pouring this right. Actually, you see this here?
Okay.
You're supposed to pour it that way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but since there's limited space.
Okay. Take a close-up of that. Let's show the proper way how to pour.
There's actually...
Wines?
A depression here on the bottom, and that's actually where you hold it. And as you're pouring it, you're actually showing the label to the one you're pouring it for.
Okay,
so here we go.
So we're having this with...
With here, the Old Amsterdam cheese.
The Old Amsterdam cheese.
Let me just switch this around. You see how the flavors complement each other?
Oh, yeah. No, I love the way, like, the combination. It's like I said, there's a third flavor that comes out with a combination. That's really good. It's really good.
So I think now we're going to try chocolates, right?
Okay, let's do chocolate. We have dark chocolate.
Okay.
Can we use any chocolate, for example, or chef, pwede chocolate gamitin natin, or hindi pwede chocolate, or hindi pwede milk chocolate. I know that, you said.
Yeah, that's okay.
Pwede.
Yes.
Okay.
Actually, for desserts, I would normally pair them with a sparkling wine.
Okay.
White wine. In this
case... We're doing this one, Jack?
Yes.
Okay.
In this case, we're using one from Spain. Actually, champagne is also a sparkling wine, but it comes from the Champagne region in France. That's why you can call it champagne.
Yeah, so not all champagnes are champagne unless...
Not all sparkling wines are champagne.
Yeah, so they have to be from the Champagne region, right?
Yes. Okay. This one is from Spain, although it's been done in the same method.
Okay.
Champagne method. Champagne method is the second fermentation which causes the bubbles. They do it in the bottle, individually in each bottle. There's a second method actually called the Charmat method where they do it in a vat. Okay, the second fermentation happens in a vat.
Okay.
Okay, and the third way is carbonation, like soft drinks. They put the wine there and they put carbon to get the bubbles.
Okay.
Of course, the price, that's why champagne is normally very expensive because of the method that's used.
Okay.
And then you could find cheap sparkling wines in the market, and that's because it's the method in which it was produced.
Oh, okay. So we're trying this with dark chocolate, I believe.
Yes.
Okay, we're trying this with dark chocolate.
Do we have the chocolate somewhere?
I think we have a small piece.
Oh, there, okay.
Over there. I presume we don't have to swirl this anymore.
We just take it as is.
Okay, so we only do the swirling for the wines, not for the champagne. So let's try this with the chocolate. Okay. Cheers. Good.
See how they go.
Good way to have chocolate.
Sweetness,
huh?
Yeah, the sweetness. Actually, the chocolate when it's dark has a bit of bitterness, okay. Right? So the dryness of the wine actually will counteract and balance the bitterness of the chocolate.
Okay. That was great. My very first time asking to do wine pairing, chef. Thank you very much. And we'll be back in a few minutes. And our next segment, we will have the staff of Forest House doing our cooking demo for this evening. And our featured recipes will be the bacon-wrapped camaron with aligi sauce, which chef will be back to pair it with. Stay tuned. We'll be back. We're back with A Slice of Life, and I'm Mano Ari. And we have a couple of winners here. The first three winners. Actually, Chef Renee is feeling gracious tonight, so with Titania Wine Cellar. So they'll be giving away more than three bottles of wine, presuming you get the answers right. So we have three winners so far. For the full name of Chef Renee, it's Chef Renee Emmanuel Arambolo. So the winners are 0943-596-2871. Again, 0943-359-62871. Next winner is 0999-122-6192. I repeat, 0999-122-6192. And the third one, 0912-670-4632. 0912-670-4632. Please text in your home names and you can claim your prizes at Forest House. We have another question, and the question is, from what region is Champagne? That itself should be a hint. Again, question, from what region is Champagne? And the other question is, from what school did Chef Renee graduate from? Okay, I'll be training the rest of this part to our chef and mega manager from Forest House. Chef and Chef Sheila, all yours.
Thank you so much, Sir Ari. Good evening, televiewers, and we're here on the third segment of, siyempre, Slice of Life for the show with Manong Ari. With me is Chef Sheila.
Hello, good evening to everyone and to the televiewers who are watching.
Keep tuned in because Chef Sheila will be sharing with us a special menu or a special recipe for Christmas holidays. We will be serving this on December 24, 25, December 31, and January 1. So our dish for today is called bacon wrap camaron with aligi sauce. Can we start now, Chef Sheila?
Yes, ma'am.
So let's shift the mood from wines to taste this food of Chef Sheila.
Ang una po natin gagawin is ibabalot po natin yung prawns. Ito po is nabalatan na po siya.
Clean and deveined, Sheila, no? Deveined, ibig sabihin, we remove the veins at the back of the prawns because this is thought gritty. Yung ibig sabihin, a little of parang yung texture niya mabuhangin pag kinagat. So we should remove that kung malalaki yung prawns na gagamitin. But for smaller shrimp, Sheila, do we need to remove it?
Ma'am, hindi na po kailangan kasi po masyado po siya maliliit. So, hindi
so,
naman
mabusisi. Pa. Okay. So, hindi naman malalasahan
hindi
yung
naman
parang
po,
sandy taste
opo.
Niya. No?
Hindi kagaya po nitong prawns na kailangan pong tanggalin po yung vein po niya.
As you can see, Chef Sheila did not season the prawns. Bakit, Sheila, wala tayong salt and pepper on the prawns?
Ma'am, ano po siya? Yung bacon po, may sarili na po siyang timpla. Medyo maalat po, kaya po, hindi na po kailangan
timpla. That will carry the taste of prawns.
Opo, ma'am.
Okay. And then, to seal it, we use
the toothpick po.
Pero later on, we'll remove it
yes,
after
ma'am.
Frying.
Yes, ma'am. Opo, ma'am.
Okay. Just to keep it tight na hindi siya matatanggal in its place.
Opo, ma'am. Okay. Ano po, pag nilagyan na po ng butter, baka po kasi, pag wala pong toothpick, baka po matanggal.
Okay. Ito po. Here is the butter. We prepared it earlier. Bakit? Kasi it will take a little time, no? Though, si Sheila will tell you the ingredients of this.
Ito po, ang ingredients mixture po nito, ang mixture po niya is all-purpose flour, cornstarch, salt and pepper, egg, and little bit water.
Oh, bakit little bit of water? Kasi yung consistency siya, niya has to stay nung medyo malapot
yes,
lang
ma'am,
siya.
Yes, ma'am, opo.
So, not too watery. Bakit? Para hindi maghiwa-hiwala yung breading natin or yung butter natin when we fry it there. So this time, at this point in time, we will now heat the pan. Pero we have to make sure that it's not boiling para hindi siya masunog. So tamang luto, tamang timpla, and voila! Yun yung best dish ni Sheila for this Christmas. Okay? Right now, we're frying the prawns already. Okay. After frying that, how long will it take to fry the prawns, Sheila?
Ma'am, about 3 minutes po.
3 to 5 minutes, I think, for 175 to 200 degrees, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And of course, while we're doing that, we can now start with the alige sauce. You know what? I am not so much into alige sauce, eh. Pero, ito, itong nakuha namin alige sauce ni Sheila, talaga namang ang sarap-sarap. We tried it. So when you make your sauce for alige, make sure that you get the best quality alige. Kasi there are some na parang hinaluan ng harina, and then there are some naman with preservatives. So medyo maalat, medyo may asim. This one, tama lang yung timpla niya. Because we got this best quality alige without MSG and without preservatives.
Tama siya na? Yes, ma'am. Ito po, habang niluluto po natin yung prawns, igagawin na po natin yung aligi sauce.
Ang it's una very po, easy, di ba?
Yes, ma'am. Opo. Okay. Ang una po, ay ito po, lagyan po natin ng butter. About 10 grams lang po.
10 grams of butter. Okay. Konti lang yung mixture nung sauce, di ba?
Opo, ma'am.
After the butter is melted, we are supposed to pour in
yung garlic po. Isutay na po natin yung garlic.
Okay. Garlic. So this is finely chopped. Okay. How many minutes do we sautay yung garlic?
Ma'am, saglit lang po ito hanggang
30 minutes. 30 seconds to 1 minute. Right?
Opo, ma'am.
Okay. And then, when it turns a little brown,
Pwede na po nating pag nag-brown na po yung bawang, ito po, ilagay na po natin yung white wine.
Wine, okay. Just to deglaze the yung garlic natin, we are using Mapu Sauvignon by Tita Nia, of course. Tita Nia has this very good wine for dish like this because this is Sauvignon Blanc, okay? This is best for prawns like this because it has fruity taste na nagbe-blend well with the sauce and the prawns. For some people, takot silang makumain ng prawns, Sheila, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Hindi nila alam, prawns is very good in fighting cholesterol. Kuminsan yung iba, akala nila, high in cholesterol siya.
Opo.
No, actually, it's high in cholesterol but less saturated fat.
Opo.
So, binabalanse niya.
Ito, pwede na po natin ilagay yung white wine.
Okay, deglaze it a bit with white wine. Mabango yung white wine and garlic, ah.
Opo, ma'am.
And then, it will develop the sweetness of garlic when you cook it with wine.
Opo. Diba? Tapos, ito po yung taba ng crab meat, crab fat. Or taba po ng talangka.
Sabi rin nila, nakaka-high blood daw to. Okay lang naman, di ba? But medyo in moderation lahat yan. Di ba? Yung taba ng talangka at paminsan-minsan lang naman during the holidays, you go to Forest House and taste it, di ba? Hindi naman siya ganong nakaka-high blood. And of course, sabi nga ni Chef Rene kanina a while ago, di ba? You just pair it with wine and then it will drop off all the cholesterol.
Tapos, lagyan po natin ng all-purpose cream. Kung gusto niyo po masauce.
Okay. That is why pala medyo creamy siya.
Apo.
Doon pala yung all-purpose cream.
Yes,
okay. Ganda ng kulay, Sheila. At from here,
okay,
I can smell
siya.
It na. So, we're about to...
Ipiplate. Okay na po yung prawns. Pwede na po
ang
natin
bilis, no?
Apo.
Very quick lang. So, we can plate it here. Or, siguro, we will just dry it a bit with the...
Tissue po.
Tissue. Or paper. Paper towel. I'll open it up. Okay. There. Ang ganda ng color, no? So, the color should be light golden brown. And that would mean hindi siya sunog, hindi rin siya hilaw. Because when you overcook yung prawns, what would happen, Sheila? Yung loob nung
Ang ano po niyan, para po siyang gummy. ano po ang tawag doon, makunat po.
Makunat-kunat siya. Opo. And that's not good. So, ito tama lang, oh. If you can see it, ang ganda ng kulay. Ang bango pa. Grabe. And with the sauce na ko, you will definitely go for it. Diba? Imagine, this is just one dish for the holidays na pwede namin i-offer, pwede nyong i-share with your family, friends. And aside from this, we have a lot to offer at Forest House. Pero syempre, right now, di ba normally we have chicken, pork, beef for Christmas. Try this dish. This is something different and I'm sure your family will enjoy it. So we'll now plate it. Syempre, we'll remove the toothpick, di ba? Para walang, delikado kasi pag may toothpick na tapos na-serve mo siya.
Oh.
Okay. Si Chef Sheila can do it with eyes closed. Talaga, grabe. At lahat ng luto nito, wala akong pinalampas. Super. Ah, just to tell you a secret ha, si Sir Ari, hindi niya gusto tong dish na to. Ayaw niya to. Kasi, sobrang paborito niya. Yun naman pala yun. Hindi niya gusto. So later on, you will see how he would appreciate this. And this goes well with mashed potato with herb, no?
Yes, ma'am.
O kaya, you can have it naman with rice then. Kasi definitely si Sir Ari, ay nako, two rice kulang yan. Secret lang po natin, okay? Baka sabihin ni Sir Ari, chinichismis ko siya. Now we're putting in the aligi sauce on top. Okay? Yan. For others, we can have it set aside on the yung sa gilid lang. Pag ayaw nyo ihalo, di ba? Pwede naman, pero for Sheila, she wants it on top of prawns. And then, after the sauce, syempre, we would serve it with mixed vegetables na buttered din. A little buttered vegetables on the side. And Sheila is now putting in the herb mashed potato. This is also a must try. Masarap. Kahit mashed potato lang, pwede na. Kaya nga nakuha ni Sheila yung kanyang husband eh. Diba na siya? Galing kasing magluto, grabe. Ay, sorry, nasabi ko rin yung secret mo, Sheila. Pero pwede pa naman, di ba? Admirers. Taken na po si Chef Sheila. Ayan. See how nice? Ang ganda-ganda ng plating, di ba? In a while, we will be serving this dish on the other table together with a pasta dish.
Yes, ma'am.
And of course, another entry for our Christmas is the dessert, which is a strawberry chocolate cheesecake to be prepared by Carla, our server at Forest House. One of the best servers at Forest House, of course. Lahat naman sa Forest House best eh. Diba? See how it looks? Ang ganda niya. Diba? Who wouldn't want to have this for Christmas? Tell me. Diba? Siyempre, luto ni Chef Sheila. If you don't want to cook this at home, just drop by Forest House. Or, you may want to reserve through me, or just take note of our numbers and then reserve through us. Christmas holidays would be definitely wonderful. And, siyempre, mas masarap, mas masaya ang Pasko kung sa Forest House natin is to celebrate. And, for now, we'll have a break. We'll be back for more.
Okay, and we're back for our last segment. Before anything else, I'd like to announce. Well, we have like tons of callers for this. The winners for tonight. Take note. 0916-423-2563. Again, 0916-423-2563. We're giving away much more wines than originally planned, courtesy of the very generous Chef Rene and Titania Wine Cellar. And the other winner is 0999-122-6192. Again, I repeat, 0999-122-6192. Another winner. How do you text via landline, no? 637-442-3012. Again, I repeat, 637-442-3012. Another one, 0912-670-4632. 0912 6704632. It is so hard to give away so much stuff, no? Thank you, Chef. The last one, 0916-423-2563. 0916-423-2563. So to all the winners, please text your names and please drop by Forest House to claim your prizes. So we're back with our super chef, Chef Renee, and we'll be doing wine pairing with the preparation of Chef Sheila and Annette, manager of Forest House. So, Chef, we have our dishes here. We have a pasta dish, and we have the prawns wrapped in the ham with aligi sauce. Super healthy. Yeah. Okay. What do you suggest? Oh, and we have our desserts, of course. Chef, what do you suggest that we pair with these dishes?
With this dish, I would pair it with some a wine that's a bit sweet.
Okay.
Okay, it'll bring out the flavor of the aligi. Mm-hmm. And the and it will sort of counter the saltiness of the bacon.
Oh.
So I have one here. This is only 7% alcohol.
Oh, okay. So, pretty low, huh?
Yeah,
7%.
So it has a high residual sugar value.
7% bagay sa akin. Easily get tipsy, okay.
You service really super chilled.
Okay.
There.
So this one should go well with the...
With the prawns.
With the prawns. Chef, let's try this.
Okay.
Let's try the sample of Chef Sheila. Ayan. We have Chef Sheila cooking for the mega chef. Let's try this. So we're doing the prawns. Chef, dig in. Okay. So let's try this thing out. Ayan. Okay. Let's try this thing out. Can you guys smell this?
Yes.
Bango, no? I was outside and I go, oh, that smells good. Okay, so let's try this first. So we're having the prawns with the
aligi sauce.
Chef Sheila. Super. Okay, so we have this with them.
It's called Natalie Sweet Chardonnay. Okay. It's an organic wine from Spain.
Oh.
You see how the flavor of the aligi comes out?
You know what, I really don't drink, but I think after this, I think I developed the habit just to appreciate more the food, right? To pair it, and there's an extra flavor too.
Mm. Yes.
Super, super. Okay, and now for the pasta, Chef.
Okay, now the pasta. Let's just switch this over.
Okay.
Maybe put this there.
On the side, Chef. Okay, thank you.
Okay. With this, the pasta, this is a ragu. I believe it has chicken,
it has
vegetable ragu. Mm-hmm. With a tomato-based sauce. I'm gonna pair it with a very nice Shiraz from Australia.
Oh, okay.
Shiraz actually was the grape used. It was discovered in the Middle East. It was actually used to make raisins.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and then they brought it to Europe, mm-hmm. And also through to Australia. Now they make it into wine.
So
it has a sweet, it has a bit of spicy flavor to it.
Oh, okay. So it is sweet and spicy.
Yes.
So we're using the same grapes that we use for raisins.
Yes, yes.
So they figured out you probably make better wine than raisins.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So let's try the pasta, Chef.
Okay.
Okay. Let's move this over. Okay. I'll leave it lang for you guys later. You can have some of this. I won't finish all of it. Whatever we don't eat, you can consume. If there's anything left after this. So we're having this with the Shiraz.
Shiraz.
With the Shiraz.
It's a full-bodied Shiraz.
Mm-hmm.
Brings out the flavor of the tomatoes. And the
right. The tomatoes comes out afterwards.
Yeah, bursts in your mouth.
Excellent combination. Okay.
By the way, the ragu is very good. I like the way it's done.
Chef, did you hear that? Right? Coming from the super chef.
Congratulations,
that must be a compliment.
It's really good.
Chef Sheila, right? Sarap lang yung ragu. Okay, and for dessert.
Let me move this here.
Smoothies over here, and let's see our dessert.
Okay, with
we have a strawberry chocolate cheesecake, chef.
Okay, with the dessert, I'm gonna pair this with a very rich Malbec. This one I was talking about from Argentina. Mm-hmm. Okay, it has a very deep, fruity flavor, and actually has hints of chocolate.
Oh,
if
really?
If you smell it, you'd actually smell a bit of aromas and hints of chocolate in it.
Chef, when you say there's a hint of chocolate, does it also mean like they put chocolate beans in that
thing?
No,
it's just, when they age the wines, it's a reserve wine also. When they age it, the wine develops different characteristics, so they have different flavors come out from it. Some say they're floral, some say they're fruity flavors. Oaky from the oak barrels. Yeah, and this ones, when they're aged really, the grapes age well, they have a deep, sometimes they have a tobacco sort of flavor.
Oh, okay.
Chocolate sort of
flavor. So this one has like a hint of chocolate.
Yes, yes.
Make it perfect for a dessert.
Normally, most people would pair dessert with white and sparkling wines, but I like to pair this with the chocolate, especially with this one, with this Malbec.
Oh. Okay, so let's try the dessert. This is care of our pastry chefs from Forest House.
Yeah. Maybe have it with a bit of chocolate, so you can...
Okay, let's match it with the chocolate so it can go well with the... And let's do this with the wine. Good.
See?
Better flavor for the chocolate
cheesecake. Right. Even the cheesecake, the flavor sort of changes. It sort of bursts in your mouth.
Right. Super. Okay. We have one more dessert. And can you please bring in, I think we forgot, one more dessert. It is the birthday of Chef Rene tomorrow.
Oh, my.
So prepare something for Chef Rene.
Thank you. Thank you.
Chef?
Okay. I have to make a wish, right?
You have to make a wish, definitely.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, Chef.
Happy birthday, Chef.
Thank you. Okay. So that was our episode for tonight. Before anything else, I'd like to ask Chef if you'd want to invite the people to your store here or even visit Manila, please.
Okay. The cheeses actually we had tonight are available here in Baguio at Dinelli Gourmet at Lemonet Hotel. Okay, actually, Titania, we are also there at the filling station right next to Lemonet Hotel. And I'd like to invite everyone to come, enjoy our wines and try our wines, which we have from 7-8 different countries. Okay, if you come to Manila, you can look me up. I'm at our main branch in Yakal, where we have a restaurant. You can look me up and we can probably discuss more about wines. I could prepare something special for you. So, thank you for having me here, and I'd like to greet everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Thank you, Chef. And before this episode ends, I'd like to thank our sponsors for this evening. Titania Wines, Fitness Edge, Nova Lodge, Burnham Hotel, Merck's, Carol Hannah, thank you so much for the OBB, Route 55, and Solane. Our guest, this is going to be our last episode for this year, so you can call this our Christmas episode. Merry Christmas. And our guests were on January 8th, that's next year, since this is when everybody starts to work out. Our guest is going to be from Fitness Edge, located at SM. Anyway, I'd like to end this evening with a story. There was a man who was walking along the beach, and the beach was covered by starfish that were carried over from the typhoon a night before. And from a distance, the man could see a kid who was walking towards him. And the kid would lean down, pick up a starfish, and toss it back to the ocean. He'd lean down, pick up another one, and back to the ocean. So the man approached him, and he asked the boy, "What are you doing?" And the boy goes, "I'm picking up the starfish and throwing it back in the ocean. Because why are you doing that? Because if the starfish stays out of the ocean, eventually they dry up and die. So I'm picking up. And the man goes, if you look around, there are literally hundreds of thousands of starfish. Can you really make a difference? And the boy picks up the starfish, tosses it back, and he goes, makes a difference to that one. Picks up another one, tosses it, and he goes, makes a difference to that one too. And so it is with our life. With all the chaos that's going on in this world, and considering how busy we are, you're probably wondering, can I make a difference in this world? And I say, yes, you can make a difference one person at a time. Help one person at a time. The help doesn't even have to be monetary or anything material. It could be something as simple as sharing a smile to cheer them up, lending a helping hand, a pat on the back to say, good job, well done. Or perhaps a hug to let the person know, I'm here and I care for you. You'd be surprised as to how much these things can make a difference. So that's one person, you, making a difference in one person's life. And that's the power of one. I'm Manuel Ari, and you've been watching A Slice of Life. Thank you, and good evening.